The seven people that include Ndahura Gathayo, Astony Muhwezi, Alex Chamanywa, Nathan Kizara Bugonjo, Bahuzwa, Monica Rashandika, and Wilbur Kiza are feuding with Lendu residents in Kapapi sub-county, claiming to be the rightful proprietors of Plot 9, Buganywa Block 1, Folio 11 at Kigorowia Kapapu, which was registered in 2005. They claim that around 2020, up to date, a number of people have encroached on their land with others killing cattle. According to Aston Muhwezi, one of the landlords, they secured a court order before they forcefully evicted over 31 families.
Don't know these people on the ground. They don't listen to them too. So you cannot sit down and see people coming up in numbers. They are coming to grab your land in 2 months' time, and you keep on to wait for court processes, to wait for, and even the court processes in Uganda, they are there for ages and ages, so it would be not wise for any other sensible person to leave those coming recently and to come in those numbers to grab your land, and you keep on working.
On Wednesday, Lands Minister Judith Nabakoba intervened and directed security to ensure that people return to the land as they investigate the matter.
See, these people have no register. They are just moving around. Yet I've visited the area and I've realized that their plots can still be identified.
Nabakoba's directives have not been welcomed by the said-to-be landlords, who have now run to court to sue her with Rogers Mbabazi, the Hoima Resident District Commissioner, and Dels Mugume. According to the notice of intention to sue seen by our reporter, the seven landlords claim that she made directives without giving them a fair hearing.
The land already were in court. Court is doing its work. And we know that where court is, there is no any other person above the law. They have to wait for court process to pronounce itself and know who is the rightful owner of the land. But when she comes in to give her directives, it means she's assuming powers beyond the courts. And for us, we feel that is not right.
During the meeting, the minister said that she was going to institute a mediation committee, which they have also protested.
I have directed the district security committee to ensure that no one return to their villages, because negotiations go on when everybody is on his own land. That's when we can achieve what we want to achieve.
And that one, we have no problem with it, but it is not a mediation as per se. And if at all we don't agree with the mediation, it means the people will remain, as he has instituted them to go back on our land, it means they are going to remain there until court process, whereby even courts in Uganda, we know that most of the time they don't finish cases. They talk long to finish cases. So allowing somebody to remain on your land, it means you have lost the interest. After all, we have not been going on our land. So we are not agreeing with the mediation. In any case, we shall agree with the minister if at all she gives us a chance and we see the way forward.
Aston adds that they were surprised when the minister was moving in a convoy with people that they are clashing with over land.
We were surprised with the minister's statement and her action, well knowing that we are the landowners and we are not invited into that meeting. She went and listened to one side, the people she wanted to listen to, and directed that the people should return to our land, which we are protesting. And we feel that was really a misdirective.
He explains that some of the people they are clashing with came to the land as tenants who are now turning against them. Muhwezi adds that when they asked the enforcement from the district security, they advised them to get a private security company, which they also did.
Process we have worked on, and 2 weeks back, we have got the security personnel who are on ground protecting our interests. And in fact, 1 week back, we have started assuming or going back to our land to at least to look after the remaining property.
According to Minister Judith Nabakoba, the land proprietors evicted people illegally with no court order. She added that the matter is under investigations by agencies and no one is supposed to be evicted under all reports and no one is supposed to be evicted before all reports are out. The minister revealed that the proprietors were invited to a meeting through RDC, but they never turned up. The contested land measures approximately 925 hectares and 1,030 hectares. Report compiled by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto for the news.